guys for hanging out. Your unspoken love and support that carries us through. So we are on D4. We just finished up D5 yesterday. D5 yesterday, Gaige was the winner. A lot of good games yesterday for D5. I'm not sure they were D5 level, but they were definitely competitive, good games. So now we're in D4. Gaige is the player moving up. We got five other players. We got six players. We're doing round robin. All of these guys are going to play each other BO1. And then the two winners, the two top players with the most points, are going on to a best of three championship to take home the $15 and to move on to D3. Excited, here we go, guys. The first game here in the Division 4 tournament. Got Fish in yellow on the left. Got RZA in red on the right. I think Fish is probably, well, certainly a crowd favorite. Obviously a big sponsor, big supporter, part of the community. But I think also his playing, he's been playing a lot with the D3 guys. He was pretty new to the game just a month or two ago, but he's been playing a lot with the D3 guys. I think Fish will probably put on a show here. I think Gaige, the winner of D5, is probably also a favorite. And then I'm not really sure from there. I don't know RZA, so we'll see what he brings. Who knows? Who knows? Map looks better. Yeah, the bottom areas need to be just slightly bigger. So now you guys see there's just a bit more room here on the bottom. It's weird. It glitches when I move it, but there's just a bit more room so you can work on the bottom a bit more. So Fish gonna come right in with a couple rhinos. Nice sentry from RZA there. Yeah, able to hold him off. So now, good move for Fish. He's gonna bounce to the outside here and try to pick on that oil derrick. Again, guys, you can't build off those oil derricks, so they are pretty vulnerable. Yeah, this is a pretty even one here. Ooh, so yeah, he does. Fish does sneak a drone in, but RZA able to counter it. Only loses one rhino there. This is a pretty good. This is a nice even matchup here. Both players now in three war factories, playing the map well, taking advantage of those early oil derricks to pump that early economy. Both only on two oils now, but RZA having a harder time here. As you see, his money's bottoming out. Fish got his third oil out a bit earlier there, and Fish's economy is looking really nice as he brings a split to the top side. Look at that D4 split. You love to see it. Three rhinos up on the top side, gonna try to start harassing that oil. See how quickly RZA is able to respond to the split, or maybe he just ignores it. Yeah, so Fish is gonna come right in now. What's the target here? Gonna target the tank. Ooh, that was, I loved everything Fish was doing until that particular moment in time. I'm not sure where both these players are from, but I would guess the U.S. because I don't think I turned us off the Cleveland tunnel. Okay, both players amassing. Ooh. And now it's RZA's turn. Now RZA mirroring Fish's tactic here as he brings a couple tanks to the top side. Fish's economy is still so much stronger here, and I'd like to see Fish, and Fish is just going to keep pumping the rhinos. Look at Fish get five war factories out here. Oh, buddy, Fish does lose an oil on the top side, but now Fish pushing it on the right side. Needs to be careful here. He doesn't want to click buildings. Ooh, missed tank control here as some of his tanks get a little bit lined up, and a couple of the ones on the backside are getting picked off. So now he's pulling back. Fish bringing a split on the top side as well now. Three rhinos going to work on RZA's oil. Fish is slightly, I can't actually, this is very even on tanks. It's hard to say for sure who has the advantage. More than likely the defender with these kind of numbers. So both players able to take out their top oils, and now so RZA has lost his bottom oil as well. So, now look at Fish from the hill there. Will he get that oil? Nice hit from Fish up on that hill, very well played. Yeah, RZA has done a good job of setting himself up, just letting Fish kind of pick him apart here. But he had a really nice build, has a nice group of tanks. But Fish is definitely getting a bit more value. Although, so now RZA, yeah, RZA overcommitted on the split there, so now he's got a few tanks out of position, so Fish is going to push in here and attack these tanks, and yeah, so with RZA very slow to respond, he had those tanks up on the top side that did not come in time, so Fish is just going to overwhelm him here. Had RZA played that perfectly, still probably wouldn't have mattered. I think he would have had to switch to a more defensive route there, possibly bunkers and drones to hold that, but really well played by Fish, and RZA making it happen as well. All right, I think the best way to do it will be to start doing, we'll start, before I explain anything, I'll say, DeSheriff, are you listening? And then if DeSheriff says he's listening, then I'll explain it. Because right now we do this thing where I explain it, and then DeSheriff makes me explain it again. And every time I do it, part of me is kind of like, hey, DeSheriff, you're the only one who doesn't know what's going on, dude, so... The top two players in the round robin play each other best of three for the championship. All right. Fish pumping early out with both players out with some drones to slow things down. I could put that note on the bracket though to share. If I think you're right, there could be a note there that says, "Hey, top two go on, BO3." All right, so Fish pumping the rhinos, Mostafa trying to pump some sentry guns to slow them down. I think bunkers are probably the better move. That's a good question. What's the price difference between a bunker that's fully juiced with conscripts and a sentry gun? Fryza, you know what's going on. Fryza always knows what's going on. All right, Mustafa's keeping up here. Mustafa's got a nice economy, three war factories, but here comes the split from Fish. Fish is splitting all day. He's a split pro. Okay. Tank engagement here. Mostafa a bit out of position, but I think does have a slight tank advantage, but is going to pull back here. Yeah, as Fish brings in the reinforcements, and Fish has these drones on the backside. Mostafa pulls back to the sentry guns. Nice. Okay, and so Fish does get that oil. Mustafa's going to try to cut him off on the retreat. Fish has more reinforcements coming here. Those reinforcements give him a nice tank advantage. Good even trades though. Mustafa's doing a good job. I think he's slightly out tanked, but doing a good job of getting the value he can out of them. Yeah, and Fish doing a good job microing these drones and not getting them lost in those sentry guns. Mostafa might be trying to pop down the middle here and try to get something done. I like how the alligators will auto hit conscripts, but they don't auto bite tanks because alligators can't eat tanks. Makes sense. So even right now on production, oh, but look at this, Fish is going broke. Fish is going broke right now. As Mostafa brings out a sixth war factory, so Mostafa now with a war factory advantage here. War factory advantage, both players now bottomed out. Damn, that sixth war factory was not the move. If Mostafa could have kept his five war factories pumping, he could have got a tank advantage here, but no reason to build another war factory if you don't have the money for it. Oh, Mustafa's money's catching up, though. I think he may have... Maybe he was trying to produce another building and he canceled it. That's probably what happened. So Mustafa now on 3K. All right, so Mustafa with an economy advantage. I love this from Fish. Fish hops on the top side, takes out that oil. Great move. Yeah, it's a free target if he can save those tanks. He got that for nothing. So great value there, obviously. This is a lot of... Whoa! Fish has a lot of tanks. Mustafa's tanks are out of position here. Oh, I don't know. What do you guys think? These tank numbers look pretty even on the bottom, honestly. Fish has a few out of position and gonna get them picked off. Now Fish bringing the split from the top side. So Mustafa's struggling to deal with the split. So now he splits off. He splits too many though. So that's what Fish wanted. Now Fish. Okay, all right, so that was good. So Mustafa held there. Now Mustafa's gotta get these reinforcements down. His base is so congested. The reinforcements are a little late to the party. He's pulling back to those sentry guns. Conscripts on the way now. Our Fish has another batch behind him. The economies have swung. Our Fish is now pumping full speed, and the yellow rhino swarm gobbles them up. Really, really well played by Fish. Some really top level stuff there, bringing those tanks on the top side, kind of threw Mustafa off. Mustafa having to deal with that split brought too many tanks, and then his congested base prevented his reinforcements from getting back in time. So that was really, really, really interesting. All right, Gaige, hop in here, see if you can slow down the Fish. All right, here we go, here we go, here we go. So Fish in yellow on the left. What's he on, 4 wins right now? Fish on 4 wins. Gaige coming in here. Gaige did just win D5, guys. Gaige was looking pretty tough yesterday. He actually won D6 too. D6 was only 2 players. I'm not sure why he was in it, but anyway. Technically the winner of D6 and D5. Well, so he's been watching Fish. He's been studying on the sidelines. Let's see what he can pull out here. Now, we saw Gaige yesterday. Gaige does have some issues with stringing out his economy too far early on. We saw last time he was trying to get 4 war factories too early. The games he won them very aggressively and very fast with 3 war factories. The games he lost, he was trying to push 4 war factories. So let's see if he's the kind of player who stayed up all night, chain smoking cigarettes on his roof, and revising his battle plan, or if he is destined to make the same mistakes again. Does have a war factory advantage here, is going to give him a rhino advantage. You see him not pumping fodder, he's very hesitant about his economy, but he does have the money for it right now. If Gaige could get 5 or 6 dogs in this group, he could probably start trying to take some pot shots at Fish, try to bait some sentry guns, try to slow him down a little bit. Fish brings out the fodder now. What are these tank numbers like? 8-2. So Gaige has 1 or 2 tank advantage right now, but he cannot engage without all of his tanks. Needs to be careful here, especially with Fish's fodder advantage. Ooh, Gaige takes the low ground here. He drives right past. Whoa, and Fish doesn't take advantage of the cliff, and Gaige kind of baits Fish into a wacky tank control situation there. I think that was actually a mistake from Gaige, but Fish wasn't able to capitalize on it properly. Fish now with a lot of fodder, and Gaige still not pumping the fodder. Gage's economy still in trouble here. You saw Gaige went for those 3 war factories early. Fish developed his economy more on the back end first, and Fish now in a better spot for it. And again, Gaige drives through this lower level. Very, very risky. Gonna go right into his base. Is he gonna dive on the MCV? Now, the question is, can he get the MCV and how quickly? Oh, he doesn't. Oh, he gets the MCV. Now he has to take some tanks with him here. If he doesn't take some tanks, Fish will counterpunch in a devastating manner. Gaige, really, really nice tank control from Gaige here. Really, really nice. Wow. And Gaige did take that one home. That was interesting. You know, Gaige, it's one of those things where, you know, your opponent, you know, Fish is a really good player. We've seen today Fish has played really good Blitz, but he's also a newer player. So when you play Fish straight up, when you do what he expects you to do, he has a plan for it. And we've seen that here today. He has plans for all. He has a very clear opening. He knows how to split. But Gaige was the first player today who was the aggressor. He came right at Fish. And he did some kind of wacky moves there, like driving his tanks on that right into for that MCV, you know, kind of gave him some weird aggressive looks that Fish wasn't expecting, just a bit unorthodox. And that's a good way to shake up a kind of a newer player like Fish, who's playing a very honed in meta, you know, give him a weird, wacky look and see how they deal with it. So Gaige does pick one up there. Yeah, that was really, some really wacky stuff there. Good game, though. Good game. All right, here we go. Gaige in red now, undefeated on the day, taking down Fish for his first win, slowing Fish down. Fish on four straight wins, then beat by Gaige. So Gaige is the man to beat right now. RZA played his first point against Fish and did lose, but played pretty good. So, these tournaments, the big thing with these round robins is everyone sees each other play so many points. There's certainly time to adjust and feel things out, change your strategies over time. Yeah, Fish got a little worn down. Yeah, it was well played, Fish. Fish, you got those splits dialed in, man. You're like a splitting machine. And the conscript rush from RZA. Will he get the... He gets the War Factory? He does! he does get the War Factory. Now the question is, can he hold? Because Gaige is bringing the counterpunch. Look at Gaige. Gaige is all gas, no brakes, man. Perfect sentry gun. Perfect sentry. Repair the sentry gun. Okay, nice. RZA is going to get over and try to grab that sentry gun before it gets... he has to be careful here. So RZA, after you get an early strike like that, that first strike early game, you just have to hold out the counterpunch, and then you have to be calculated. Because, in the next minute or two, hopefully you will get an edge. But for the time being, you might be slightly behind, depending on what your first strike cost you. I don't think it's buffering, Minka. I think it's when I move the map like this. Is this what you mean? Okay, engagement here. Ooh, engage is... Oh, and RZA needed to pull back to the sentry guns earlier, try to use the defensive advantage. Another nice sentry gun, but Gaige is going to keep these tanks pumping. He's got a vet. The vet goes down, though. Oh, RZA doing a great job hanging on, but Gaige looking so tough. Lot of sentry guns there. Even with all those sentry guns, though, Gaige is just pumping these rhinos. Not sure how he's getting so far ahead on his rhinos, actually. Does grab the MCV now. RZA in a lot of trouble. Oh, the elite, but the elite goes down. Yeah, so now RZA kind of has to try to bring a counterpunch here. Doesn't really have enough to do anything. Two vets, though. If RZA gets lucky and picks up an elite, maybe two elites. Okay, has to target the tanks. Switch over to the tanks. I love this from RZA, being so hungry here, playing off that higher ground. The sentry guns. Oh, picks up the elite. They're going to take that oil. Oh, my God. Oh, this is so sick right now. The elite tank comes in from RZA. Oh my God, and I love this from Gaige. He's just pulling back. He knows he has his MCV. He knows if he can find a way to hold through this, he can make something happen. But look at this micro, that control from the elite. And RZA, sometimes when you go into like sell the farm mode, you get a little distracted on the back end, but it looks like RZA does have his War Factory waypointed, and Gaige calls GG. What a banger. Wow. That was fun. That was really fun. Jesus. All right. Fryza, you were putting up points in that mini D4 tournament, though. Mostafa in red, RZA in yellow. Versus Slicer. And Slicer is D5. To be fair, Slicer, we do know that. Yeah, we'll run a floating fish map today. We can do that. All right. We'll get it dialed in, guys. We'll get it dialed in. It's hard. We got about 60 players. So, hard to keep track of all the players. Slicer trying to get into D6. All right, RZA in yellow on the right, Mostafa in red on the left. RZA, the man to beat right now, looking very, very tough. Mostafa going to send it down the middle. We haven't seen many people using the Gator Pit here. A bit difficult. There's a bit of a choke point coming down the middle of the map, and you see that sentry gun right there from RZA going to kind of shut things off. Makes it a bit difficult. Does open things up, but I think it's more of a kind of a backdoor tricky business move versus like a primary move. Nice sentry gun from Mostafa. Yeah, it's just we're just gonna do Slicer versus the Sheriff in D7, and it's just the first person who can figure out how to build on the cliff wins. You don't even have to fight each other. All right, RZA bouncing around. Now Mostafa does have 4K here, so we can keep pumping these sentry guns. RZA is broke, but his economy should catch up with him pretty quickly here with these four oils. Neither player bringing out fodder yet. Yeah, no timer. Yeah, you're right, Fish. You gotta get more than 10 minutes for that. Okay. All right, so for the time being, Mostafa slows down RZA. RZA's been a force these last couple points. Okay, all right, a little low on the action here, but I like to see that because that means Mostafa's keeping up. But you guys saw now look at Mostafa's economy versus RZA. So RZA's economy's caught up nicely here. Mostafa in a bit of trouble. Ooh, and Mostafa went 5 war factories. It's really difficult to underestimate, you know, 3 to 4. It really seems to be on this map specifically, especially early game, bringing out the 5th war factory is very, very risky. Not only does it speeds up your production, so your money's going down faster, you're bottoming out, but it's also 2 grand, right? A war factory costs 2 grand, so not the move. I think that move to 6 for Mostafa could cost him here. He's gonna start falling behind on Rhinos, and RZA is the kind of player that's gonna make him pay for it. Well, I feel like there was a message. Someone said something about the stream. I'll go back and scroll through. Lots of chatters today. Thanks for hanging out, guys. Appreciate it. 8 conscripts early game. Go down, try to harass your opponent. If you can't get anything done, you pull back. You use them as fodder before the Desos come out. I think that's a great move. That's what I was trying to say, okay? At some point when the lawnmower was here, I was talking about conscripts early game. 8 conscripts early game, I think it's a great move if you have the bandwidth to pull it off. Targets the war factory. Man, we've seen that a lot in these lower divisions. Do not target buildings when you are in a tank fight. It's not worth it. He's got 8 war factories. Taking 1 war factory does nothing. And in the time all of your tanks shoot 2 or 3 shells at that war factory, you're going to be getting pounded in the side by his rhinos. It's just not worth it. Nice split from RZA here. Just a few rhinos on that bottom side getting some stuff done. Mostafa doesn't really know what to do about it. He doesn't want to pull his tanks over, so he's just kind of AFK. So his new tanks coming out should be able to hold it off. Only loses 1 war factory, not so bad. Gonna push in again here. I don't think Mostafa really has the tanks to push here. I like the aggression, but I think he actually needs to be playing defensive and considering are going higher ground here. So here's the move. There's no reason to attack from the lower ground here. Attack from the higher ground. The lower ground has rocks and hills and shit. Come top ground, you get some free shots in. Okay, there we go. Now he's playing the hill. Yeah, higher ground. Higher ground's powerful here. I think that's the move. Oh yeah, that's what we call it, harvesting the new players here down in D5, D6, D4. That's where they come from, man. The new Kian. Any one of these players could be the next Kian, the next Octo Kid in the making. Not much of a defensive advantage here for Mostafa. We don't see many sentry guns in the mix. The yellow storm overwhelms. RZA is a beast. Mostafa put up a good fight there. It's just kind of hard. Like, the question is, so you think, okay, my opponent's going to bring 1,000 rhinos. What do I do? And you got to try to counter it. You know, you can't just trying to go rhino to rhino with someone who's better at rhino wars is hard. Oh yeah, so all right, so now Gaige and yellow on the right, Fryza and red on the left. Yeah, so the thing is, it's funny. So if we do a five-way round robin, it's really hard. You know, six-player round robin is a lot of games. So you kind of have to, you kind of got to run it in the way that's the fastest, which is having the winner stay on. I blame Snark for that one. The Sheriff, you're in D4. We blame Snark. Yeah, so, but anyway, the other way, I mean, the way to do it where it's more suspense is to have the loser stay on, because then you don't see, like, who's dominating early on, but anyway. The biggest thing, honestly, is, like, these lower divisions are an opportunity to get players out playing games, and then to see where players should be, you know, and trying to filter players into divisions that are more competitive. Yesterday, I mean, it was blind luck. We had a bunch of new players, and they were all very competitive games. Today, like, I don't know, three players that are all playing really well, and then three players just slightly behind. It's not, you know, these games really aren't like blowouts. A couple of these guys, Gaige, Fish, and RZA are just being very dominant today. To Sheriff, the problem is, man, if we just keep bailing you out by dropping you down divisions, I'm not sure if you're ever gonna really pull out that grit that's needed to dominate. You know what I mean? You should be like, you know what, Ivor? I should say, hey, to Sheriff, we gotta move you to D5, and you should say, Ivor, no. Like, I'm hungry. I want this. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna practice. I'm gonna train on the map. Me and Fish are gonna run drills. He's gonna teach me how to split like a pro, and I'm going to crush people. Don't you dare move me down. That should be the attitude. Hungry. I play for fun. Well, everyone plays for fun. Let's take a poll. Is it fun getting crushed? What's more fun, crushing people or getting crushed? I'm just kidding, Sheriff. I don't care what you do. You wanna go to D5, go to D5. You wanna go to D6, go to D6. You wanna leave, leave. You wanna play, play. Just don't ask me questions that I've already answered. That's my only rule in this stream. All right, both players massing armies here. Fryza, I like Fryza hanging and banging, because Fryza, you know, if Fryza was lesser of a man, he'd be like, hey, screw D4, I want to go to D5, I'm going to pretend like I'm even worse than I am. But instead, Frieza's like, no, I'm hungry, let's go. Let's try to put points up against the champ and make Ivor's life easy by not creating a three-way tie. Up on the cliff now, bit of fodder in that mix. I like this for Fryza. I think the dogs and the conscripts with good tank control, which is the opposite of what that was, lost a couple tanks on the retreat. Do not think Fryza needed to retreat there. I think the tanks were about even and had a slight fodder advantage. But Gaige is scary. Gaige is an aggressive player, and you know, his aggression, you know, aggression does make players think that their opponent is outmatched. Like, if the opponent starts attacking you, you think, oh, he must be up because he's charging at me head first. But it can also just be a battle tactic. Split now from Fryza on the bottom side. Two rhinos going to go pick on that oil. I like that. Gaige brings out his fifth war factory now. See that? So when Fryza retreats, he gets his tanks in that line and gets in trouble. Now it's hard to say. Now I think Gaige has a tank advantage. So now Fryza probably does need to play off the sentry guns. But like I said, guys, Gaige is like Zoolander. He only goes left, except that Gaige only goes topside. Gaige only attacks from the topside. So that's what's nice. It makes it easier for his opponents to defend because he only attacks from the top side. Yeah, Fish. If Fish wins all the way through to pro, he'll win the money back he donated. He says to win like five divisions and then beat Kian. I think that's reasonable. But I like that Fish is like, yeah, I'll put money up. And it's like, oh, that's very generous. He's like, no, I'm going to get it back. It's my incentive. Now I have to get the money back by winning five divisions. So yeah, Desolators on the top side to slow down Gaige, since Gaige always attacks on the top. I like those Desolators. Nice. Yeah, I think a cage match would be funny. Like, Like, we do, like, that old Alamo map that's just flat, and we do Kian versus, and just all, every D4 player that wants to can sign up, and whoever lasts the longest versus the Octo Kid gets the prize. Okay, a lot of tanks from Gaige, a lot of tanks. Fryza again forced to pull back. No Desolators here to help. Love to see some Desolators in the mix here. That's one of those things that's kind of funny to see, though. Like, in the lower divisions, you're like, this looks similar. Like, everyone's building Rhinos. Rhinos seem to be important. Yeah, but the differences are, like, what's on the back end. And, you know, at the top level, by now, we're at the five-minute mark, Desolators would be dominating the field. You know, at the lower, Desos take a lot of micro to deploy, to undeploy, to keep your units off the radiation. Then the opponent's bringing in drones. There's a lot to do with Desolators, and they're very, very tricky. We do have an Iron Curtain out and a Kirov now out for Gaige on the right side, as both players do push tech. But Gaige is going to get in the water. Gaige does have a battle lab and some money, so I think we're going to see a Dreadnought from Fryza. But Gaige is there with a couple Rhinos to counter on the top side, able to get through that radiation. He needs to pull back those Desolators on the bottom side to protect a bit more. So bad missed tank control here from Gaige. Does lose a few tanks. Would love to see those Desolators get in there. Can the Desolators on the backside doing a bit of chip damage, but Fryza's just way too out-tanked right now, unfortunately. The Dreadnoughts are out. The Dreadnoughts are trying to shoot the Rhinos. Well played by Fryza, but yeah, Gaige is looking really, really tough. All right, we are going to run these. We're going to run these three games, best of three, but we won't do another tiebreaker after this. So if it is a three-way tie, it is going to come down to point spread. Fish, RZA, and Gaige, they all went 4-5, or 4-1 in the prelims, so a three-way tie. So they're all going to play each other best of three, to see who the winner is. In the event that they each beat each other once and lose once, say Gaige beats Fish and then Gaige loses, you guys get it. If we have a three-way tie, it'll come down to who won on point spreads. So if you can 2-0 someone versus, you know, beating someone 2-1, and then the final tiebreaker will be the person to win the point the fastest. If everyone has the same amount of wins, then it'll come down to who won the fastest point. Neeb-a-me. You're right in time, man. You're here for the championship. Oh, yeah, the timer's been off all day. That's hilarious. We have had a timer in all these games today. I just noticed. Oh, Slicer, man, the early, I remember the early LAN days, like the first time I ever system linked Halo, and we were able to play Halo in two different rooms. Because the old days you play Halo, but everyone just looked at each other's screens. It was like part of the game. The first time we system linked and played Halo in two different rooms, it was literally the best thing that ever happened to me. It was the most fun I ever had in my life. All right, so the first time today, first time in the tournament all month, we've seen Allied come out now. RZA bringing out the Allied, bringing out the Eagles, bringing out the Paradrop. Fish is going to get down and harass that oil. Should be a pretty good game here, guys. You know, we got all three of these guys in the championship now. I've been really banging out. But I love this. And Fish is not able to get that oil, but he does pull out before he loses his tanks, which is smart. Now, we haven't really seen an Allied look yet. So Fish drives right past. It's a lot of Grizzlies here. Fish needs to be careful. Picks off an Eagle, but Fish is losing his tanks here. So now Fish has to switch over to flak tracks for anti-air, and in the process, it puts him behind on the land battle. This is a problematic amount of Grizzlies for Fish. Fish has to throw the flak tracks out as fodder. Unfortunately, flak tracks are completely useless versus ground units. Fish learning that lesson the hard way here. Really, really nice micro here out of these Grizzlies from RZA, and very, very tough match here for Fish, point number one. Yeah, I have a group, like my eight friends from high school. We still get together once a year, and we bust out all of our Xbox Ones, and we still do a LAN party. Just play Lockout, Shoddy Snipes. It's still the best, honestly. Okay, Paradrop doesn't get anything done on the backside. And so RZA giving Fish some room to breathe here. I don't love this. I think that RZA is way up, and in general, you know, you got to drop the hammer. But at the same time, as the allied player, you know, the longer the game goes, the better generally. So posturing up, bolstering here with the Mirage tanks, the tech, I think it's a good move I think dropping the hammer is a better move probably, especially a player like Fish who's been playing so well today. I don't think there's any reason to give him extra room to breathe, but honestly, these Mirages are just going to continue to advance his position. Fish has been playing very, very high level Soviet, but he's been playing Rhino War Soviet. Fish hasn't really been doing much with tech today. I don't think we've even seen him go tech. So, you know, he's bringing a lot of rhinos, he's bringing a lot of splits, and he's doing that very, very well. But ultimately, you know, you can't smash rhinos into mirages over and over and over again. It just won't work. So, you know, for RZA to sit back here, get the mirages out, just going to continue to advance his position. Fish on 5 war factories and not really looking to diversify, even though he's on 7k. He has to get the Iron Curtain out, he has to get the Dreadnoughts out, the Kirovs. It's the only way to break through the allied player once the Mirages start pumping. These Eagles are just going to keep picking Fish apart here. Wow, actually, you know, these 5, you know, oh my, you're right, that's a lot of rhinos. But RZA, it's a lot of Fish actually. If Fish had fodder right now, he could push. This is a lot of rhinos. I feel like, oh, RZA is on 3 war factories. I'm a little confused here. RZA needs to be considering, RZA is on 8k. He needs to be building more in the pillboxes. He could be building a lot more stuff right now. Where are the Rocketeers from RZA? He needs the Rocketeers, and the Dessos are coming in now from Fish. Wow, RZA. So RZA bringing snipers now. RZA on 9k. The Rockies. There should be Rockies. There's no flax in that group right now. Ooh, RZA sneaks the Mirage out and grabs that one Desolator. Snipers going topside. Snipers need to come bottom side to help with these Desolators. Yeah, the snipers are getting a little confused. RZA has a difficult to defend position. Needs to take out those Desolators for sure. I'd like to see, I need Rockies from RZA. The Rockies would force Fish to switch over to flak tracks and try to slow down this Rhino Storm. RZA pushing up the middle here. Oh, look at him doing work from across the water, but the Rhino's doing some work as well. Interesting little exchange here. I think RZA is getting some good value out of it. Does pick off a few Rhinos, but Fish is just continuing to mass Rhinos as Fish does switch over to tech now. Battle Lab out. What an interesting game here. We are at the 6-minute mark. See if either player can break through before the next 4 minutes. The defender on this map's a little tricky. Your units are difficult to control. Your base kind of messes up your pathing a little bit. Oh, RZA just stopped building. Yeah, that makes sense. And now we do see the split. The split from Fish. A couple elite Grizzlies topside. But Fish does stay alive on the top side. Yeah, okay, so RZA made a couple crucial mistakes there. RZA was not building macro. The buildings weren't coming out. He had way too much money. He needed to continue to progress, whether it's oil or elsewhere. He needed to keep building. Also, his Eagles were not staying busy. These Eagles need to all be hotkeyed. He has 8 Eagles. He could have been swooping on these Rhinos for the last 5 minutes, just picking off these Rhinos, weakening these Rhinos. Fish is still not going to be easy for Fish here. That's a lot of Mirages, and Fish not able to get a Deso bomb off. Deso's coming. The Mirage is on radiation now. The Mirages are popping. Oh, the Mirages melt on that radiation, and Fish able to take it. An absolutely beautiful play there. Wow, and RZA had that game early, had the game mid, and just let Fish, like I said, guys, let Fish breathe. But I did not think RZA was going to be able to blunder that position, but just kind of fell behind in the mid game there on the back end stuff, not producing enough, not using everything in that allied arsenal. The Eagles were AFK, the Rockies never came out, and then Fish was able just to, was just able to hammer through with those Rhinos. Wow, very interesting. All right, so point number 2 here, it is best of 3. So if, oops. Um, Yeah, I mean, RZA really fell behind there. I mean, that was just, it was just mistakes across the board. His base wasn't expanding. His Eagles weren't busy. His Rockies didn't come out. I mean, it's just like, and then early game, he could have dropped the hammer. RZA was so far up early game. So it was really well played by RZA. You know, I don't want to just be critical or negative, but unfortunately, that's unfortunate for RZA. Even early on, RZA could just won with the Grizzlies early game. RZA fell back to build the Mirages and then just didn't fully flex the way the Allied has to play. Got himself a little too contained in his base. Wasn't able to expand, and Fish made it happen. But hats off to Fish for staying in it, keeping the pressure on, and making him pay for it. I mean, you know, a lot of times in those comeback situations, yeah, it does take one person making mistakes, but it also takes another player capitalizing on it. Fish really committing to flak tracks right now. Way too many flak tracks. Way too many flak tracks. You need like three flak tracks, maybe. Tesla Trooper's out now. I'm sure he just overclicked. Now juicing up the flak tracks with Tesla Troopers. I don't know what's going on here. I'm excited to see how it plays out. Cliff 3 Sheriff 1. Yeah, Gage, you'll play the winner of this. Paradrop topside. Paradrop coming in. Eagles coming in. But Fish now counterpunching nicely. Needed to use those Eagles to slow down these Rhinos. Ooh, nice tank control there from RZA. Oh, but gonna lose the Eagle. Are those Eagles juiced up? Ah, the Eagles still don't have their bombs yet. Tesla Troopers doing some work here. Oh, that veteran Rhino. And that veteran Rhino's right on the verge of going elite. Okay, it does take it down. But the Rhino's still coming now from Fish. Nice paradrop from RZA. Nice counterpunch. But can RZA stay alive on the front line? Yeah, Fish playing Soviet the way it needs to be played. Very, very fast and aggressive. Not letting the Allied player get comfortable. And RZA, yeah, RZA just, RZA was trying to go aggressive there, using the Eagles offensively, using the paradrop offensively. And, you know, to be fair, Allied's very difficult, but, you know, RZA could have used the paradrop defensively, could have used the Eagles to, you know, if you get four Eagles to hit four Rhinos, those are four Rhinos that are about to pop, you know, half strength. So RZA does hold on for the time being. RZA on 12K. RZA has 12K right now, dude. Pump it out. The barracks is AFK. The war factory's pumping Grizzlies, thank God. What's the barracks doing? Where's the AFC? Where's the pillboxes? Spam the pillboxes. Pump the Grizzlies. Pump the GGIs. Hold the position. Hang in there and try to make something happen. Fish pulling back now, posturing up, getting the Rhinos and the dogs out. RZA with so much money right now. Yeah, Fish needed to, Fish could have continued to press there and tried to take a little bit more, but RZA coming out of that with so much money is very problematic, and Fish goes broke. Fish goes broke, and Fish is now in trouble. He's gonna try to push in here. That's a lot of Grizzlies, but nice tank control from Fish, playing that top side, playing the higher ground. Needs to really avoid these pillboxes. He cannot afford to get in battles with these pillboxes. And Fish, ooh, this is tough. The Eagles all dropped their one bomb on one tank. He wasn't able to micro the Eagles. Fish is gonna dive on the MCV. He is gonna get, oh, he does get the MCV, just barely pays a really high price for it. So now, Fish needs to pull back. Fish now in the death triangle. Look at all those pillboxes diving on that war factory. Fish, you gotta pull back from this position and defend. And here comes the counterpunch from RZA, and Fish is broke, so there will be no sentry gun support here. Fish doing a good job baiting these war factories, using them as meat shields right now, which is the absolute right move with the MCV advantage for Fish. He needs to switch over to drones, just try to hold this position. The Rockies doing some work here. RZA and Fish going for the base trade now. Oh my god, what a wacky point. RZA correctly pulls back to defend. RZA now down on one barracks and one war factory. RZA has to defend this barracks or the war factory. All right, so Fish does pull back here. So Fish with the MCV, but Fish is broke. RZA has to keep the gas on right now. RZA gonna come right down the gut. Fish's money. Oh, those GIs on the top side doing work. But can RZA push through right now? RZA's got three Eagles for support. If RZA sits back, RZA is going to be in trouble. He can't really afford to sit back here without the MCV. Fish wants this game to be delayed. His economy's finally catching up with him. RZA's on 15K. Now the Rockies are being pumped more. The Rockies can join in. The Eagles come in, hit a barracks. That cancels the sentry gun. I think RZA's got to keep the gas on, right, guys? I don't think RZA can afford to sit back here. Just trying to find an opening. Going to attack down the middle. Rockies now coming in. There's a lot of flat cannons, though. And Fish just knows if he can buckle down and make it through the storm right now, he has a chance to, he should be able to close this game out. But RZA has the AFC, has the War Factory, has the barracks. So the fight will continue for the time being. Gets in, not able to get that barracks. A missed tank control here. I'd love to see, I think RZA just needs to get in the open field. RZA has a lot of grizzlies right now. I mean, RZA could attack. Oh my God, I just pointed at my screen. You guys can't see my screen. Yeah, I was gonna say that top side's looking nice. RZA getting up on that cliff, using the higher ground here. But Fish has a lot of fodder, has to be so careful here. This is so hard. You have to try to target the rhinos. You can't afford to have your grizzlies attacking the fodder. A little missed tank control here. Fish should be able to get the upper hand and close this one out. Wow. Yeah, RZA, 25K, nothing to do with it. Fish is storming down the gates now. Yeah, really, I mean, well, you know, good game. I mean, heck of a game by both players. RZA definitely ahead there. And Fish had a nice, Fish dove on that MCV and then was able to hold the position. And, you know, that's, I think that is, you know, that's a play that needs to be in the book, you know, in your playbook. If you realize early game, hey, I'm screwed, I'm down. If you can dive on the MCV, pull back and hold the position, things can swing. Things can swing very, very quickly. Well, not quickly in this case. We're at the 8-minute mark. So Fish needs to switch things up. We're at 8 minutes. Fish needs to use his advantages here. RZA has the Trinity, has the barracks, the War Factory, and the AFC. So he's pumping everything he needs. I'm not sure about the switch to GI. Yeah, GI is over Rocky. He's just going to try to hold, I guess. Fish should be able to win this land battle. The rhinos versus grizzlies on the top side don't really make sense. Fish should be able to win that. But then Fish is going to need to get some desos in here to deal with these GIs. The question is, Fish can win this. The question is, can he win it in 2 minutes? And I think it's going to be difficult. He's just, I think he's a little, Fish has kind of lost the line a little bit here as to what his strategy is. And I think RZA should be able to hold through it. And this one's going to probably come down to points. Fish needs to try to engage these grizzlies. Get a desolator in position and click the buildings. RZA doesn't have that many buildings. Honestly, Fish could try diving on the buildings. I mean, Fish doesn't want to blunder it, obviously, but yeah, Fish doing a great job cleaning up those GIs now. I think he could grab that barracks. Nice, grabs the barracks. Now I think he should probably be engaging the grizzlies. Yeah, that's a decent amount of grizzlies, though. Does get the barracks, so that slows down his infantry production. Oh, two tanks out of position, going to get melted. So we only have 2 minutes left in this game. Legend! In the house. Legend in the house, studying the D4 guys, trying to get tips and tactics. That's what it's all about. Avid tanker like comes in every stream and says something like that, like, yeah, well, Blitz isn't the regular game. Thanks, Avid tanker, very helpful, buddy, we appreciate it. It's not the normal game, you are absolutely right. Okay, Fish able to close it out. Wow, there's only 15 seconds left in this game. Oh, RZA does him a favor and quits out. I think Fish would have been able to close it, though. So Fish takes it home. Gaige hop in here. So now we got Gaige versus Fish. three players that tied. They went 4-1. So now they're all up here. We're doing a round robin championship. So Fish just beat RZA. So if Fish beats Gaige, Fish wins. If Gaige beats Fish, then RZA and Gaige have to play. So Fish versus Gaige. Let's get it going. Gaige in red, Fish in yellow. Did the YouTuber? No, I don't think I got raided. I don't know where these guys came from. Anyway, guys, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching the stream. I appreciate it. This is the Blitz tournament. This is Division 4. So we're running tournaments all month long here. Moving up to the pros. We'll be running a bunch of pro games next month with all those big players you guys know and love. Got $300 in prizes going out. And the best news of all is we're doing it again next month. A new map, a new tournament each month. $300 in prizes. And there's divisions for everyone, guys. So we have like 7 divisions. No matter what your skill level is, come play. There's the Discord. Join the Discord. Sign up for free. Win cash prizes. Hang out. Make a bunch of friends. Be a part of an awesome community. That's what it's all about. All right, so here we go, guys. So Fish did just beat RZA 2-0. So Fish trying to dominate in D4 here, trying to take home the cash prize and move up to Division 3. Again, Division 3 is gonna be tomorrow, same time, so stick around for that. So Fish looking pretty strong, although RZA could have won both those games as allied, but Soviet versus Soviet, Fish is looking so tough. But Gaige has been playing well. As you know, he came up from D5 yesterday. He's very comfortable with the Rhino Wars, and that's what Fish's specialty is here. So let's see what happens. Those players pumping the Rhinos early. Gaige goes for that third war factory early on, which is a bit tricky. Sometimes he gets into situations with his economy. Fish bringing out a drone now, gonna sneak that drone down the middle, try to get in, take a rhino out. See if it works, we'll see if it works. So now Fish preparing a split. He's got three rhinos coming on the bottom side, and this is what we've seen Fish do all tournament long, and he's done it very, very well. He splits his rhinos up, and he gets value. He gets down, he takes out his opponent's oil. But in this case, his split is going to put him at a defensive disadvantage here, and now you see Fish bringing these three tanks home. He did not have the numbers to split there, and Gaige is going to take advantage of his rhino numbers, and now Fish's reinforcements late to the party here. His sentry gun's a bit late. He does bring the sentry gun closer to the MCV to try to defend the position, and he is able to hold, but Gaige now bringing in reinforcements, and Fish did get a drone in, and so now Gaige, yeah, you see Gaige kind of questioning himself there, was thinking about pushing, but that's a lot of sentry guns from Fish. So Gaige, yeah, trying to find an opening here. Gaige now bouncing down to the bottom. It's nice to see this more diversified look from Gaige. We've seen him attacking from the top side all tournaments, so mixing things up now, trying to get away from Fish's sentry guns, I think is a great move. Okay, nice push. Takes out that sentry gun, and you see Fish bouncing behind his war factory, trying to use it as kind of a human shield there, playing off of it, but he does have the tanks now. Yeah, Fish is gonna look to counterpunch here, but Fish is broke, so Fish is broke right now. You saw him, his money just bumped up because he canceled his war factory that he was building, so Fish has a little bit more money to continue the press here, and he does have a tank advantage, but Gaige is on 5K. Gaige hasn't built any sentry guns. Now Gaige brings out a nice sentry gun right in the middle of it. Should be able to hold this position, but Gaige should be looking to get some fodder in the mix here. Conscripts or dogs would really help him tilt the tides. Tilt the tides? That's not right. Tip the tides. Tip the tides? Is that a phrase? Tip the tables? I'm mixing things up. 2 hours in, my witty remarks end up getting a little bit less witty. Oh, but now Fish looking tough. Fish is broke, but he's scraping the bottom of that barrel to get every tank he can on the front lines. And Gaige still not bringing out the fodder. If Gaige was able to bring some conscripts, a bunker, some dogs, he has the money to try to give a different look here, to try to defend his position better, but he's just pumping the rhinos, and Fish is out tanking him. Turn the tides. Turn the tides, got it. Tilt the scales. All right, good job. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Yep. Wow. And speaking of turning the tides, Gaige pulls ahead here. Fish, so Fish was not continuing to reinforce that attack. If you're not going to reinforce the attack, pull the attackers out. There's no reason to keep those rhinos in there. Send them to their death without any value. But Fish does have the tanks to defend now and quite a few sentry guns. So another exchange, and what a back and forth, an absolute banger of a match. Both guys at each other's throats, banging it out right now. The attacker to defender switch has been constant all game. The aggressor, the upper hand, just keeps shifting here. And Fish again is going to split two tanks bottom side to try to take out that oil. And very risky in a rhino fight like this. Those two tanks that Fish just took to the bottom left could cost him this battle on the top right. But look at Fish's fodder. Every time you see a dog get hit in the face with a tank shell, that's one tank shell that's not hitting your tank. That's why you call it fodder. They're there to take hits, absorb damage, and it does make a big difference. So Fish, it was able to get down there with that split. Those two rhinos were able to take out that oil and get home. So pretty good exchange there. But Gage's economy is looking nice. Fish's is looking even better. Look at that Fish now on 8K. So this is what Soviet versus Soviet Rhino Wars is all about. Now, at this point, who can maintain their rhino numbers and effectively make the switch over to tech? Get the battle lab out, get the Iron Curtain out, and start diversifying while also holding the lines with their rhinos. And that primary war factory from Fish could cost him this. Look how far the tanks are having to drive to the front lines. If he would have had that front war factory primaried, those tanks would have been there that much faster. Attacking one by one will never work. Engage now comfortable to start attacking buildings. Gonna dive on this MCV. Can Fish hold this position? Two more tanks join the fight. Oh my God. Wow, this is so close. The back and forth. Oh God, never mind. Another wave coming. Yeah, once you're on five war factories, by the time one army dies, there's another army coming. I thought Fish had just given a heroic hold, but Gaige was like, that was just wave seven. I got wave eight right behind it. And it looks like with that, Gaige is finally able to punch through and close out this game. And what a first point. Gaige picks up the elite, takes out the MCV. Nis needs to target the buildings here, target the tanks. Drones out from Fish. With the drones and the conscripts, Gaige is going to get so much value out of this. Can he get one more war factory? Yeah, he does. Oh, and he picks up the elite, and there goes the last war factory. And so that'll be GG. Gaige, really good decision making there in the heat of the moment on that attack. That's why Soviet versus Soviet, good old-fashioned Rhino Wars right there. Desolators? Nope. Tech? Nope. Rhinos. Rhinos for days. You guys are thinking, Ivor, you got a cool lair when there's like really an epic battle. You got like a button you can push where something cool happens. Glad you asked.
Press the doom.
That's the official banger lair when we got a battle like this. Both these guys fighting tooth and nail coming at them right now. Best of three. So Gaige, if Gaige can win this, Fish is knocked out. If Fish can win this, we go on to point number three, which will obviously be wildly entertaining. It's what the people want. We want the barn burners. We're here for the bangers, man. We're here for the excitement, the entertainment. All right. So very, very even first point. Now the question is, what did these players learn from that? I mean, both players gonna go Soviet again. Both those players played the game that they wanted to play. They played the game that they've always played all tournament, and they played the game they're the most comfortable with. But also, they're playing the game that their opponent should be expecting. And so the question becomes, will one of these players pivot? You know, will we see the exact same game again? And at the lower level, oftentimes that is what you see. You know, these D4 games, the players have a very honed in strategy, and that's kind of like they give a single look. You know, both these guys are rhino smash, and they don't really have any trick plays or backdoor options. I mean, they don't have anything crazy up their sleeve. Now, you know, at the higher level, you'll see a player bring, you know, one time they GI rush, the next time they go air, the next time they, you know, or the rhinos come out early, then they push early tech. So there are different looks you can give, but at the lower level, you know, the more difficult it is to have multiple strategies that can really work. And in the championship, obviously, you don't want to be like, oh, I have this wacky trick play where I bring V3 rockets on the cliff, and then you get stomped out. So I think we will see both these players, and as I say that, you know, drop right into Rhino Wars again. But it'll be interesting to see if either of them feels like they can push tech a little bit earlier. You know, the Iron Curtain would certainly tip the tides. But at the same time, like I said, if it puts you behind on the Rhinos, you're going to lose the game for it. And Gaige already ahead here quite a bit on Rhinos. Bit of fodder in the mix. Fish does get a nice hit, decent value. Just needs to now be careful of this counterpunch from Gaige. Gaige is going to get up on that cliff, probably try to take out that oil if Fish doesn't contend him. And it's going to be tricky for Fish fighting uphill now in this corner. Nice sentry gun. But yeah, Gaige throws that fodder out in front. Fish, and again, see Fish not using a good primary war factory. His tanks having to come from the top side and are getting a little late to the party. But again, Fish able to hold the position. Gaige doesn't get a much offensive value out of that, only taking a single sentry gun, not able to get an oil. So far, offensive value does go to Fish, although Gaige does seem to be slightly ahead on tanks. Okay, so Gaige continued to keep the pressure on here. Fish, nice, kind of hopping up on that hill. Good tank control. Playing off that cliff's really, really nice. It's a very top-level move from Fish. You go up on that cliff, try to get the higher ground. Really, really like that. Okay, so now we'll see. Oh, so Gaige, now look at those guys. Whenever you see a smoking tank like that, that makes a big, big difference. The smoking tanks, those weak tanks are going to pop very, very fast when the battle comes. But you see Fish does have a few of his own as well. Now, both of these players now have the money to bring in a bit of fodder. We've talked about, you know, before how big that is at the top level. You almost always see it until the Desolators get involved. The dogs, the conscripts, just a handful here could really tip things, you know, with tanks being so even. And then obviously the defensive advantage for Fish, the sentry guns to help out. But Fish now goes broke, so Fish did push Battle Lab. So that's the question. And Gaige brings out another War Factory. Fish was already on five, though. So the War Factories are even. The question is, did Fish have the money to buy that Battle Lab? He gets another oil out now. Fish is going to try to push tech, but the Iron Curtain's so expensive. The nuclear reactor's so expensive. You know, all of this takes time. It takes money. And in the process of doing that, is he going to fall behind in this tank battle? That's the question. We'll see here. Fish. Oh, questionable tank control from Gaige as he drives through the base. Fish's tanks are lined up, but Fish has him severely outnumbered now. Gaige needs to pull back and try to defend, but it's going to be very difficult. Gaige is all gas, no brakes. He's an offensive player. And as I say that, he now brings out his first sentry gun. But too little, too late. That's a lot of tanks for Fish. Fish hits the MCV. He goes and sits on the MCV. Just sits there, doesn't even shoot it. Gaige quits out, and we bring ourselves to game number three. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Okay. Yeah, I mean, and it's difficult to appreciate. You know, you think like, oh, you just throw the tanks into each other and whoever has more wins, or you toss a coin. But the tank control, you know, every single decision that you tell your units to do is going to affect their ability to attack each other. You know, their ability, you know, they're like the pivot on top of the tank, the way it turns and shoots. Those microseconds make a huge difference. So tank control is everything. And in that case, yeah, you mean it's every single battle, and ultimately Fish was able to come out on top there. So this is point number three. Now, normally we have that 10-minute game timer. If the timer goes, the player with the most points wins. Because we're going on, this is the match point, so we did take the timer off. So if this game goes 2 hours, it goes 2 hours. All right, so 1-1. Now, if Fish wins this, he wins the tournament, right? So Fish will beat RZA already. If Fish wins this, he wins the tournament. If Fish loses this, then Gaige and RZA play each other. So everything's on the table right now. But man, Gaige has certainly been making Fish work for it today. Even that last point really tipped both ways a few different times. So again, let's see. And I think we're going to see the same kind of thing. Rhino Wars coming right at each other. And just see those minor decision makings. This series so far has been all about tank control, micro, and those little tiny decisions that are hard to even perceive from up in the booth. NGs can heal. Oh, like you put an NG in a tank? It'd be pretty expensive if you put an engineer in a tank. Oh, you just mean like the engineer goes up to it and repairs it, like a mechanic? It's kind of cool. There's actually mechanics in this game where you can make a hijacker unit. I think maybe the terrorists were originally supposed to have it, but the unit, basically, he can run into an enemy tank and take it over. Kind of a cool mechanic. We were talking about trying to incorporate that in some free-for-all games. All right. So here we go. Here we go. This is it, guys. Division 4 on the line right now for Fish, if he can clutch this one out. But he's got to be cold-blooded, man. He knows you guys are watching. He knows we're up here judging him and questioning every move. Is he the kind of player who feeds on the pressure? Or is he the kind of player who's going to crumble here? And we'll see. That's what they say. You know, pressure makes diamonds, but it also crushes people and makes them cry. So we'll see what kind of player Fish is here. We'll see if Gaige can extend this series and try to give himself a fighting chance. Both players beginning this Rhino dance early on, but Fish mixing things up a bit here with this Battle Bunker. We haven't seen that yet in this series. Barn Burner, that's absolutely right. Where's the Barn Burner graphic? There it is, Barn Burner, guys. Barn Burner of a match, banger, coming down to the match point like this. Both these players really care about our entertainment, which is great, very selfless of them. All right, so Gaige gets down, does take out that oil very easily, but he's not able to pull. So when you attack an oil like that, if you can, you want to pull your units off so they don't get that splash damage. So look at Gaige. Gaige now has three smoking rhinos, and we'll see if Fish thinks he can push here. Catches a couple tanks on the retreat, but Gaige, it's about even right now, but Gaige has a few smoking tanks. That's a big disadvantage. Oh, Fish does too. About even. About even. All right, so Fish on but Fish way up on economy right now. Fish must have differentiated his build a little bit here. I didn't catch it, but Fish has defensive structures, two bunkers juiced up, more sentry guns, five war factories, and he's on 6K, and a radar out. Keep an eye on Fish's money. He's got a nice build here. He's got five. Oh, okay, he's got one oil. Yeah, so he got his oils out a little bit earlier, and his economy is definitely benefiting for it. Gaige just really pumping rhinos right now. I would think Fish could pull back to a defensive position here with how much money he has. I would like to see him be looking to get behind that bunker and extend this game. So Fish does bring out the battle lab now. So Fish is looking to close this game out a little differently, and I love that. That's what Blitz is all about. Point to point, playing things differently, anticipating what the other player anticipates you anticipating, and then making them pay for it. But I like Gaige. Gaige definitely has good map control right now. That's really nice. And I would like to see him continue to keep kind of bouncing to the top and the bottom, just kind of keeping Fish on his toes. Fish has a difficult time getting his units in and through his base. Defending the top and the bottom is tricky once your base gets so gummed up. So now Fish is out with the naval yard. Fish just needs to hold this attack, and very questionable tank control. Gaige gets six tanks on that bottom level, wiped out by that bunker, and that was enough to severely give an edge to Fish in that position. That was six or seven rhinos completely blundered by Gaige, and now the dreadnought out. And I love this from Fish, you know, defend, and then counterpunch. What's your offense? And in this case, he got the tech out, he got the dreadnought, and the dreadnought's going to work cleaning up these war factories. Fish has more than enough tanks to hold this position, and these dreadnoughts should be able to easily clear things out, and worst case scenario, the Iron Curtain's on the way. But there's really nothing for Gaige to do here. And with that, guys, unless something crazy happens, the dreadnoughts, look at the dreadnoughts split up, each just melting targets right now. War factory's going down. Gaige calls GG. Fish takes it home. And with that, our three-way championship comes to an end. Wow. What a treat. And I love seeing Fish mix things up there, bringing out the tech, bringing out the dreadnoughts. Really, really well played, and a great build to keep his economy rolling, to keep his tanks in the game. And so that was those, we don't need to do the RZA versus Gaige, obviously, because Fish won both of his games. So Fish is the champ. Let's grab him a crown. Fish is your D4 champion, guys. He's going on to D3 division.